Okay, push the record button. Oosh. This is Ham Radio Now, episode number 424, Ham Cam International. Hello there, I'm David Goldenberg, W0DHG, and I know it's been a while, but I'm back and hoping to bring you more shows coming in the 2021 year. This will be the first episode of 2021, and I visited with the folks from Ham Cam International. I'll put up their information in the banner there, Ham Cam International. You can contact Mike 1, Echo Alpha Kilo at btinternet.com, or there's a website there, and I'll put that in the show notes. What is Ham Cam International? Well, Ham Cam International is it's a group of folks. They have come together over the internet using a tool called JITSI, and they talk about amateur radio. They help support each other. They provide technical support. It's kind of like Zoom, but free. And this group is, as in their name, it's international. When I first got the call from them, when they reached out to talk about wanting to be on the show, I thought to myself, well, how is this amateur radio? And I'll tell you, after visiting with them for about an hour, it is amateur radio. And especially now with COVID and how things have changed, you know, we're in what I like to call our new normal. We have to adjust, and this is a group of folks that are international. I think that they said they're over 100 members right now, and they have adjusted to lockdown and quarantine, and they're still able to participate in amateur radio. One of their goals is to provide opportunities for folks that are in antenna-restricted areas to actually be able to get on amateur radio. They support each other. They help them. The other members of the group try out new amateur radio things. In fact, during the end of our call session, one of the members came in, and they've been playing with one of the internet-based D-Star variants, and they went and helped him get it hooked up and connected so that he could talk to them. And I think that's really great. I think that, you know, it shows the best of our community, how we can support each other, how we can keep this moving forward, even if we can't get together in person. I don't know about you, but this last year has been it's been a drastic change in my amateur radio life. Some parts for the worse and some parts for the better. We've missed a bunch of events that we used to do in person, but we've also had a lot of more connections, you know, via this kind of media, Zoom and some of the other internet-based applications. I'm going to more amateur radio group meetings than I've ever gone to before. I'm hosting more than I've ever hosted before. It's a different format. It's a different media, but we're seeing more people show up to a lot of our events than we'd seen in the past. And we've been able to bring more folks into the fray. We've taught more different technologies. And I think it's different and it's great in a certain way. Again, Ham Cam International, you can contact them at Echo Alpha Kilo at btinternet.com. And we'll show this again at the end of the show as well as in the show notes. I hope you enjoy my interview with them, and I hope you'll check them out if it's interesting to you. And without further ado, the folks from Ham Cam International. And let's talk.
Okay. Thank you, David. This is K3BEQ. My name is Murray. I'm located in the state of Maryland, Washington, D.C. metropolitan area. And thank you so much on behalf of the membership, Ham Cam International, for doing a podcast. It's a relatively small group compared to others. We have about 100 plus members who enjoy the video. And let me give you a little background on how it started. About 2 years ago, two hams were continents apart, one in England and one in California. The gentleman in California is a truck driver. He still is. And he drove his truck through the remote regions of the desert out there in California. and it was pretty remote. The roads were virtually empty, and he got to talking to this other hand in England. They decided to communicate not only audio, but video-wise. They started out with one other system, but they decided to home in on a system called JITSI, J-I-T-S-I. It's a free video system available to anyone. You establish certain communication rooms, and they did so. And it was a relatively small, much smaller than we have now. It was about 15 to 20 members. And we used to watch Frank as he drove through the deserts, the Mojave Desert, delivering his product. And he would do that 6 days a week, very early in the morning till around noon. Well, after a while, the group expanded to about 20 to 25 members. And it was decided to do some tours. For example, when we joined, I decided to do a video of Washington, D.C. from my mobile. We drove around the various sites, the Capitol building, which is prominent right now, the Pentagon, through the streets of Washington, D.C., the memorials, and so forth. It worked out very well. And then it was expanded. Some of the guys in Europe and Hawaii gave demonstrations of their various historic places there. So it went on and on. We had these tours coming up. One of the more interesting ones was the memorial to Korea, the Korean Memorial, the Vietnam Memorial, and the World War II Memorial in Washington, D.C., and that was recorded and went very well. Bob, out there in Hawaii, he's on here now, he did a tour of a historic place on the island of Hawaii, which came out very well. The group, as I said before, is now 100 plus. We meet regularly here. It's kind of an informal group, David. Mm-hmm. There's no set pattern, but we do have the time differences, and because of that, typically Europe is five hours ahead of us here in Washington, D.C. But they usually come on during the hours that I mentioned in my previous email to you, and it's quite informal. We talk. We care about each other, and I tell you one thing, David, we protect each other. There's no caustic remarks here on this particular system. We're very friendly, but we're very protective of each other. At one time, we had some intruders. You know, with any particular virtual room that you have on the internet, you're always going to have intruders, particularly if you start growing. So because of that, they were playing a little bit of havoc. We had to go to a password on this particular room. And since we did, there's been no intruders, which is a welcome sight. We have a Facebook that's subsidiary to the group where we pass on update information and keep the members informed. Plus, we have all their email addresses. And if it's something urgent or informative, we'll send it out that way. Now, what I'd like to do, not everyone, I don't think you have the time for it, but I'd like to send it around to a few guys and let them tell their views. And one of the more interesting and important things that we consider here, David, is that for those who do not have the capability of putting up a regular amateur radio station, this is a blessing. There's absolutely no question about it. Can't put up an antenna. Those who have financial difficulties and cannot put up a station, this is something that keeps their big toe in the water, so to speak.
I think that's great.
I'm going to turn it over here to two of the more senior guys. And by the way, everything is volunteer, David. There's no bylaws. There's no rules. There's no president, vice president, treasurer. Not that we charge anybody. Everything's free. And it's a free-for-all, but it's very well disciplined. These guys are all professionals. A lot of them are retired. Some are still working, but it has been my distinct pleasure to be associated with this group. And I'll tell you one thing, and you may chuckle, that if I don't see the individual anymore, I don't enjoy going and just using audio. It's got to the point, and I'm not alone on this, that I so enjoy seeing the individuals, their expressions, their contact, that I don't want to be bothered with just audio anymore. And it's kind of an obsession, and it takes hold. Okay, let's see. Jim, how are you? Jim just came on from Scotland. And I'm going to turn it over first to Colin and let him say a few words how he feels about this group. Again, I'm not going to go through 16 or 20 people unless you want me to. But Colin, go ahead.
Yeah, okay, Murray, thank you for that. And I'll quickly go through a few bits what makes it very interesting to me. First of all, like Murray said, it's the friendship you build on here. I've been licensed for 27 years now, and I've had 27 years speaking into a mic, which, don't get me wrong, I've really, really enjoyed. But when I come across this was taking it to a different level, because you're seeing the person you're speaking to. And not only that, we've helped each other so much on here, because you can physically show what your problem is. If you've got a problem with your computer, we can share the computer screen. We can see each other's computer screens. We can take control of each other's computer projects. We share projects. So yeah, I like it because of that, the friendship I've made on here. And it's really laid back. We have a laugh on here. We know there's a time and a place to be serious, but a lot of the time, and I'm probably the biggest joker on here, I do like having a joke and a laugh. That's what it's all about for me. But there is times to be serious and that. And one of the times is, one of the bits I do is the membership. So all what I would say, David, if anybody wants or has got an interest, if they just look me up on qrz.com with a call sign M1EAK, my email's good on it. Just email me if they're interested, and we'll ping them an email back with a relevant information on. And that's about it, but it's a great system, and I recommend anybody just come in and give it a go. Even if they just put their head round the corner, try it for 10 minutes and go, no, sorry, not for me, or great, I love it, I'll be back. And that's all we ask. Go on, Murray, back round to you, my friend.
Oh, fantastic. Give him your call phonetically, please, Colin.
Yeah, the call phonetically, sorry, is Mike 1 Echo Alpha Kilowatt.
And your email?
The email is Mike 1 Echo Alpha Kilowatt at btinternet.com.
Phonetically?
Yeah, I got it.
Oh, you got it? Okay.
Yeah, no worries.
I couldn't understand. Thank you, Colin. That was great. Another core member is John. He's up in the upper can corner. 2 Echo 0, Papa Sierra Victor. John?
Yeah, good day again there, David. Yeah, the only thing I'd like to add is, Colin basically put it out there that some of us are quite technical to the point we can help other people that are not technical with computers and stuff like that. And we help them do whatever's going on, whether they want their PC speeded up. We do have more than one room. We've got another room without a password in, which is open to anybody. It's only this one that is basically dedicated to the amateurs only room. But there is a Ham Cam 2 room that everyone's welcome to use. I stand to be corrected with that. And yeah, it's all a lot of fun, and certainly enjoying the hobby. And yeah, it's opened up. It's a bit like FastScan, but a lot more sophisticated, quite easy to use. Back to Murray.
Hey, John, what was your call?
2 Echo 0, Papa Sierra Victor.
Very good call. Thank you, John.
That got it?
Yeah.
Okay. Tristan, want to say a few words. He's our youngest member. Just had his birthday on the 7th. So happy birthday, Tristan. Say a few words to David.
Very good evening to you, David. Sorry, the camera, I think, has something's happened. Maybe it's, I need to plug it in. But yes, it's an honor to be a part of this group and being able to speak to you this evening for the first time. As Colin and John mentioned, this is a wonderful platform. I've enjoyed being part of the community, and it's just great that we have this, as Marie said, for people that are not who don't have room to put a shack up, and we endeavor to help anybody as much as we can, from computers to amateur radio. And I think this is a nice place where we can share our expertise and help each other. That's good. I think if we work together and help each other, it's a very much nice way of, you know, the friendship and the being able to help each other, and being able to not just let you be, they can tell you, hang on. Yeah, and it's you know, they could tell you, "Oh, we're not going to bother helping anybody. Let them plod along themselves." We're not like that. We're all here to help. I would say that I'm good with IT, but there's some things too technical, and I just can't grip it. But there's always somebody on here which are willing to help, and I'm really very grateful to be part and to be able to share the friendship and be able to get more people on here. Thank you very much there.
Thank you. Thank you so much. So are there other folks that, Murray, that you wanted me to speak with?
Yeah, one or two more. I'd like to take you to Hawaii,
okay. The
Big Island, and turn it over to Bob. We call him Kona Bob, Alpha Hotel 6, Golf Tango.
Aloha there, David, and it's great to see everybody. And as Colin mentioned, I think it was Colin, once you start doing video streaming, it does make it kind of hard to go back to audio only. I'm very busy with 40-meter nets out here in Hawaii, and I enjoy 40 meters a lot out here in the middle of the ocean, but we don't get too many people with interesting accents. So when I get on here, I get to hear Colin. We make each other laugh. I get to hear Murray there. Everybody that comes on is just a delight. I just enjoy it so much. It's kind of like, for me, the anti-FT8. FT8, you're making many, many contacts, but you know nothing about the person you're talking to, and you're getting no culture. Here, we get plenty of culture. I can even play my ukulele on here, and it's legal, which I've done. And I'll tell you, one of the funniest things was for New Year's Day, we had a little party here. I played Auld Lang Syne on my steel guitar, and you've never heard so many people trying to sing Auld Lang Syne. It was hilarious.
That's great.
Anyway, I do appreciate all the friends that I've made here, and thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Bob. It's my pleasure to join you guys. I think this is great.
David, one of the things we did, quite unusual, we had a meeting on the day before New Year's. And after the meeting, which was very short, we had a social gathering. And we had quite a group of, I think, 26 people checked in. And a lot of toasts, a lot of laughter, a lot of guitar playing. And it was so nice that everyone had an enjoyable time to bring in the new year. Some of the members reached the new year well before we did. So I want to just mention one thing that I think is important. Some of the purists out there, ham radio, and I've been an operator for 70 years, and I've been DXing and so forth, but some of the purists believe this is not amateur radio. But I think, David, we have to change our minds. We have to open them up. In the old days, It was all HF, and rightly so, because there wasn't anything else to compare. But what with the internet and Echolink and a lot of the other systems that have come along, I think we have to change our minds about amateur radio. Now, not as a replacement, but as a addition to the Radio Shacks. There's so many complex communication systems that are available that it's certainly wise to make use of all of them. And with that, I'll turn it back to you, David.
Well, you know, I think that's great. And you know, you started to answer one of the questions that sometimes some of the topics I cover, there will be part of the audience that will come back and say, well, how's that amateur radio? And I thought the same thing. I'm always open to talk to anyone. And, you know, anything can be a good show. It's really about bringing this out. And as I scroll through, I've been scrolling through your faces and your pictures. I'm on, whose tile am I on right now? I'm on somebody's tile with a Z that's got up APRS FI for, I can't even exactly tell where it is.
That's the Zello room. That's a link we've got off Zello, David, which John runs for us.
Okay. And where are we looking at?
If you go to the bottom, there's four little squares, uh-huh. And if you click that, you'll get everybody again.
Oh yeah,
it
there
lets
you go.
You switch between.
Yeah,
the
oh yeah,
two.
I've been scrolling through the different pictures, and I guess part of my point was that there's amateur radio here. I saw somebody's Colin's got his radio up on one of the screens, and then somebody else has got John's got a whole bunch of SDR. Stuff going here. You guys are tracking the International Space Station, and I think, you know, it is amateur radio. This is definitely, last year was definitely a different year for all of us, and one of the things that hasn't come up at all is COVID. And you know, it begs the question, you know, I know I still work, but my job of going to an office every day has changed a lot, and a lot of what I've changed to is doing meetings like this from right here at my station, outside in the shack or in my office, where I see lots of faces. And in the work world, we don't turn our cameras on. And I really value what you guys do. There was a comment about seeing other faces and not just listening to the audio. I think, especially nowadays, it is important. It's important to have those connections. It's important to be seeing people and being able to reach out.
The good bit about it, David, sorry interrupting you, quickly picking up, is on the COVID. It's helped me through COVID so much while we're in lockdown. Yeah. And I think everybody, because not being rude to my wife, it's just me and my wife here, but 24/7 to actually be and speak to other people and interact. And I'm sure it's a lot. I know Tristan goes to a special youth centre and he can't get there at the moment. So he's in the house on his own because his mum's still working, and he comes on here and he's with us most of the day, and it's great for all of us, not only him, but we interact because of the COVID and we spend a lot more time, and I think it's brilliant.
Yeah, absolutely. Yes. You know, I'm, you know, as you said, you know, it's you and your YL, and you know, there's five or seven people in my house, depending on whether you count my parents that live in an apartment over my shack here. But it has been a hard year. And we are limited, and part of my circle of amateur radio has grown. You know, the first month as we got into this, our Aries group, you know, I'm a assistant district emergency coordinator for the Aries group down here. We put on our first Zoom meeting, and I think we're up to 9 or 10 of those. And in some ways, I was shocked that we started to have larger turnouts than when we used to go and meet at one of our local hospitals, because it's easier for people to get here. Almost everybody turns on their camera and everybody's there. And I think we're all very lucky to be able to make that, yes, you know, face-to-face communication. Mm. And I think that's huge.
I might add, and thank you, David. CQ Magazine, February issue, will have a feature article on the group. Streaming video over internet protocol is the title. Please look for that. Or you might want to mention that.
Absolutely. Well, you just did. And I'll include that for sure. And I'll see if I can't find a digital link to the article and point folks to it.
Let me ask you something, Steve. How does this work now? When do you broadcast? How long is the broadcast? How many people? What's your audience volume and so forth?
So I don't specifically broadcast it. It's a podcast. So what'll happen is I'll do some post-production later today. So I'll do an intro and then I'll do a closing. And basically what I do is I turn it into a video and I post it on YouTube and on my website. And I'll also strip the audio out so it's just audio. And I post that to my podcast feed. We link it to a Facebook group. I have a Facebook group as well. And, you know, depending on which one of those sections that you look at, there are 12,000 people that subscribe to my YouTube feed. Now, do 12,000 people listen? No, not all the time. Typically, you know, we're talking 1,000 or 1,500 people will start or look at a video. Some of them will say, hey, this isn't for me, and then they move away. And then some of them will listen all the way through. It's the same thing with the Facebook group. Some of the folks will look at it and say, that's great. And there'll be other people that are in there. And I know there'll be people saying, this isn't amateur radio. And that's okay. That's their opinion. We're all entitled to our opinion. And so there will be, you know, potentially in a week or two, you know, 1,000, 2,000 people will have viewed some or all of this. Some of the shows go bigger. I've had a couple shows where I've got 5,000 or 6,000 views all the way through. A lot of it just depends on the topic. Things that are more controversial get longer views. Things that are a little more niche have shorter views. A lot of it just depends on what sparks someone's interest.
Excellent.
Again, I honestly think that I think it's what I think Colin maybe said it is, you know, there's a lot of people, we listen all the time, we listen. This adds another level. The whole idea that you took this, JITSI is a free platform, and it's like our Zoom or our Teams or anything else anybody else is using, but it gives you the ability where in the old days, if we could, and it was non-COVID, I'd drive 20 minutes to another ham's house and help him tweak a setting here or change a setting there or do a test or set something up or give him access to something they didn't have. You guys can do this here live on the fly. And that, to me, that's part of what makes the community stronger, right? I think that this is awesome. Somebody's got a video there going on the beach.
That's Hawaii.
Yeah, that'd be a great place to be right now, huh?
Yeah, I mean, sorry, Murray, go on.
I'd like to ask two favors. On the podcast, is it possible for you to put up in print Colin's?
Oh, absolutely.
If it's okay with you, Colin. You know, the addresses.
I'll include Colin as the contact and his email address. If you want, I'll post the information about the Facebook group. Is there other links or places you want me to point folks towards?
Just the address for the membership chairman, Colin.
Okay.
And the Facebook URL.
Okay. Not a problem. Easy to do.
That'd be great. Anybody have any additions that they'd like him to do? Just speak up one at a time.
I saw Stuart raised his hand there.
Would like to add that I'm a member of a bunch of different clubs. I've lived abroad for years, but the whole COVID-19 thing has made me extremely isolated in Eastern Europe. So I find this to be very useful. And I think the main thing is that people think this is something like competition to amateur radio, and it's more like an online community, an online club. Now, I actually belong to a virtual club in the UK, and if nothing else, COVID's meant that we are much more active than when it didn't happen. So not everything's bad that's come out of the whole COVID thing. For example, in my other club in the UK, they use Discord as their platform. Mm-hmm. But we come on to Zoom for what is called a pub night, and that was yesterday. Now, with JITSI, we do that pretty much every day. Not all of us are on it every day, but we're all here. Everybody's got different backgrounds. Everybody's got different, so it's a very, very diverse group. We haven't got anybody from South Africa today, but or New Zealand, but we've got people from pretty much every continent. So it augments rather than, so it's like a club, basically, you know. So people don't ask when they go to the club, you know, why aren't we talking to each other with radio, because we could use handhelds across the table. It's nice. That would seem ridiculous, but when we use this, people sometimes ask that sort of question, you know, and I see it in Facebook groups and other things. But really, it's just a bunch of us getting together. And even today, we were on here earlier before you arrived, setting up Droid Star. It took us maybe about 5 minutes to do it on here. But if you tried to explain to somebody over radio, can you see this button at the top over on the left? Well, you know, I can just go, it's here, look.
Right. Absolutely. And I've seen with other groups, too. I did an interview and a show with the Long Island Amateur Radio Group. I think that's the name of the title. And their big thing is CW classes. And if I messed up their name, I apologize. They started doing the Zoom stuff a couple of years ago. And they have several thousand members. And they get together in this format on a regular basis. And they're training new CW operators all the time. Mm-hmm. I think more and more and more, what used to just be, you know, that started off with a spark gap, right, and then went to voice, is expanding out into more and more. You know, again, I got my Go Box here. I got my Winlink station. You know, I have a Winlink gateway here. We are doing more and more digital things, more and more different things. As you just pointed out, you know, I have been able to attend more and more club meetings stuck at home than I could have ever done, you know, locally, because
of course
it's, hey, I'm here and I can do this one, I can do that one. And it has actually, for me, while I haven't been as able to do as many of these shows because of work and other responsibilities I have, it's allowed me to engage with more hams. And I think that's great.
I think, David, one of the reasons we're a little bit more unique is that we have these tours mm-hmm. of interesting places around the continents and around the countries. And I think that's a little different from the normal club meetings and so forth.
Sure. And how does that work? So somebody says, hey, well, I live near this cool thing, and I go do some video tours of it? Is that kind of
well,
how you do it?
Well, for example, we'll set it up in advance, give the members the time and the date. And we'll go out in our mobiles and visit the Vietnam Memorial or visit the World War II Memorial. Mm-hmm. Or in Hawaii, Bob will visit one of the interesting places on the island.
That's awesome.
And the other thing was, Murray, the other thing was worth mentioning as well, I think, is we're very diverse on here, that anything goes within reason. It doesn't have to be amateur radio. Yeah, I mean, we've had Bob in Hawaii. He's a baker by trade. He's been talking about how to make different recipes, etc. So it's so diverse on it. Then we could be talking about a computer and someone's got a problem and there could be two of us trying to sort it out. Then we're talking about satellites, Oscar 100, the geostationary one. So it goes on and on and on. And that's what I like it, because you're not just sitting here talking about amateur radio all the time. I mean, it doesn't matter if you talk about amateur radio, after a while, you're all going to get bored with it to a certain degree. So to go off on a different angle is quite nice. So yeah, I just wanted to put that in. Sorry for jumping in, Murray.
No, fine. There's no boredom here. Go ahead, Jim. Jim's in Scotland.
Yeah, good afternoon, David.
Good afternoon.
Call sign here is Golf Mike Zero, Mike Yankee Quebec, GM0MYQ, and the QTH is Aberdeen on the northeast coast of Scotland. I do quite a bit of streaming when I'm in my job. I do deliveries here, and I've also, not all the time, but a lot of the times I stream from the front window. my phone. I just shove it on the tucker on the window, and when I'm doing deliveries, people see Aberdeen daytime and nighttime. I must say congratulate Murray, Colin, Tristan, and the rest of the group for keeping this going. It's a fantastic thing. It's never been boring. It's always something. We've always got some white cracks on here. Colin and I normally joke. Colin's a coffee man, and I'm a red wine man. And I'm on here quite often. I've streamed the videos in the shop here, actually. I'm working in a big shop with 32 cameras. I've actually walked around the shop and told them, or showed them all the alcohol, all the good food. It's actually Asians that own the shop, and it's Polish food, Romanian food, English food, Scottish food. Well, there's everything in it. We're a 24/7 shop. Anyway, nice to meet you, David. It's nice to see your station in the background there, because there's quite a lot of equipment. You know, a kind of guy like ourselves, we're technical guys. I'm an ex-IT engineer. I've been retired quite a few years now. And you come. Somebody coming in here. And I'll pass it back to you, Murray.
Okay. Thank you, Jim. It's one of the good guys. Kona Bob, Hawaii.
Yeah, I just wanted to tell you, Murray, some of the guys know about it. But I run these 40-meter nets out here in the islands. And yesterday, Gary there in Canada, VA3 Golf Delta Zulu, he was on JITSI with me. And at the end of the 40-meter net, the person who was net control said, "Does anybody else want to make a comment?" So I patched Gary in just by holding my microphone up to the computer, and Gary got to say hi to everybody in Hawaii. They were thrilled. And right after that, about six people came over onto HamCam 3 and met Gary, and we all had a good time talking there too. So I enjoy introducing JITSI to the hams out here in the islands. Over.
David.
I'm very pleased to take part of that beef 40meter.net. Once in a while, they're open. So that's a funny thing. But this area is a very blessed thing. I've learned a lot of things here. I'm listening for two reasons. For the social part, and from getting more technical information. So here from Austria, I'm very pleased, and especially now at the coronavirus times. So it's a great thing. Back to you all, Murray.
Thank you, Eric. David, would you like to hear from others, or do you have enough?
Yeah, so you know what? Well, actually, you have some questions to ask. Somebody's got some feedback, so if you're not talking, mute yourself. I'm not sure who's coming through. I hope it's not me. Oh, that's better.
Yeah.
So yep. I have a question, and anybody can answer, Murray, or you direct it to somebody. If you had an ask for, you know, my community, you know, we're going to share this out with my community. What's your ask? Do you want to grow the group? You want more acceptance? You're looking to, you know, expand your footprint. You're looking to inspire others. What can the amateur radio community do to support or join or just be aware? That's one of my goals on bringing new things to other hams. What do you think that would be, Murray?
Well, as far as this group's concerned, and I would say that, we would give this advantage to those who enjoy this type of system, communication system, and particularly those that can't or are restricted from putting up regular stations, regular antenna systems. If you're in that particular boat and you can't join in, come in here. We have a great group, friendly, informative. And why not take advantage of this particular video system? Not as a replacement, but as an addition to your own shacks, if you happen to have shacks. And I think that's essentially it. We'd like to grow. One of the things we don't know about, David, is how many people can check in at one time. I've heard hundreds and hundreds, and I've even heard thousands, but I'm a little skeptical whether or not the system can handle that. But we're not sure. The maximum we've had is close to 30. We've never had 100 people here, and some of our computer gurus, Colin and John, are just we're not certain what would happen. Although JITSI corporate members say they can handle hundreds and hundreds. Anyway, that's the gist. We'd like to grow, and we'd like to offer this particular system and our organization to those who wish to join in.
But the problem is if this place take more than 100 people.
Yeah, I will tell you. I'll tell you honestly from my experience. I have a professional Zoom account. I can do 100 people, and in a round table like this, if you get over 30 or so people, it does get a little bit disorganized. And what we end up doing, and I don't know if JITSI has this capability, this is kind of my first experience with JITSI, is we break them out into rooms, right? And we say, hey, who's interested in talking about HF today? And who's interested in talking about Windlink today? And who's interested in, and you break them out. And you guys, I know you guys already have HamCam 1 and 2 and 3, and who knows? I can see that as you grow, as an option. But I think that folks will look at this and I'll join. I'll definitely bookmark you, and I did go to the Facebook page and I put in an application, and I could see while I'm home working in the shack or here or even inside doing my regular work to pop in and visit and say hello to folks, because I think we do need more social interaction, and it's hard sometimes to find, and I think this is the key for me and hopefully for some of my listeners, it's hard to find folks that have a common interest in, our hobby. And it's a big hobby, but, you don't go down the street every day and find someone who's an amateur radio operator. It's clear when you see me driving down the street, because there are several antennas on my truck and, my call sign on my license plate. But it's not something that you see everywhere. And when I talk to people about it, they say, do people really still do that? And yes, we do still do that. And I'm glad to see all of you doing that. And I think you found a great platform for it. I saw somebody raise their hand. Dennis, do you want to say something?
Dennis, go ahead.
We can't hear you.
No audio. No audio, Dennis.
Oh well. Bob had some.
Yeah, I just wanted to say that if you talk to Colin or you talk to John, it is so simple to set up a room that, there may be ham radio, maybe people listening to your podcast that think, gee, I wish I had a group or a way to talk to my local group here. There's so many people that I'd like to see their faces more often. It's quite easy to set up a thing that they could run in conjunction with their VHF nets or whatever.
Yeah,
it's a big world.
So I do have a question about that, Colin. This didn't cost you guys anything? Did somebody pay for the JITSI?
No, it's completely free.
Okay.
Completely free. You can just go onto the URL, put the URL in, and make your own name up, and the room's there. And the room is yours as long as you're in it. As soon as you drop out of it, anybody can go into that room. Mm-hmm. But when you've got one person in, like any one of us in here, we can put a password. As long as one of us stays in there, that password stays active. As soon as you drop out, the room gets cancelled out.
So how long have you guys had the HamCam 1 room going?
How long is it now, Murray?
Well, the original group with the two guys started about, I'd say, a year and a half ago, maybe two. And then there's been some organizational changes and growth. And the real thrust of the group started about 8 months ago, where we really gained membership. It's relatively young.
Yeah. No, there's nothing wrong with that at all. I think that's great. Yeah. Well, I will look into that because I can see this is a good, would be a good, as somebody said there, that this would be a great supplement to our UHF VHF nets, you know, to be able to see what's going on, what people are doing, and especially as we encounter jammers sometimes, it'd be great to have a back channel to work around those things. All right.
Streaming now, Don, David.
Yes.
Streaming now, mobile.
Oh, yeah, we see you there driving around.
And it's okay, a little damp in Scotland just for a change. Obviously, it's not like that normally.
Yeah.
Gary, did you have something to say?
Yeah, Gary, I thought we should just acknowledge that point that it's really, I see it as a supplement. We've tried it three different ways. You can't hear?
No, there's
no your audio quality is too bad.
Okay, yeah. I'll come back later.
Okay.
I think you're okay now. Try it. Oh, well.
Can you?
I think Gary was where the noise was coming from before. So, yeah, I mean, that's really my goal is, like, what do we do? How do we share this? How do we make it interesting? I hope that we grow your group. With folks that, you know, would be a good part of your community that, you know, need the support and can help support you in other ways. And like I said, I will definitely check in occasionally and see how it's going here. After I put the show all together, I'll send Murray a link. You guys can all check it out and see. And there are about 400 shows in my library, about 250 before I joined and then another 150 since Gary and I got together and then since Gary left. Did you want to try again, Gary?
Yeah, is Gary, the audio coming through at all now?
That's much better.
Yeah, fine now.
I just wanted to follow up on that point that it's really, I see it as a supplement. Mm-hmm. We've tried it three different ways, trying it separately, just as a chat room, but you have to be prepared for the visual aspect, like to share something. Mm-hmm. Go on a tour, show your shack, show some pictures, some that kind of thing, because you have to be prepared to contribute that, and that's where this room adds value. That's separately. We've tried it together with Annette. I did it with Bob just last night. I really don't think it works. It's too distracting, but what you can do is you could mute it on this and continue with your regular net over the radio, and some of the people who you may never have met, you may have talked to these guys for years, but have never have seen them and never have met. Now you can see them and they'll be talking, but you really can't do two at once because you go crazy with the time delays. And then again, the third thing is you could do it afterwards. And I'm trying that with some of my local nets. I said, guys, we're done the net now. I've got something I want to show you. I went up to the cottage and I saw some really interesting pictures. Anybody who wants to, after the meeting, let's meet on Jitsi and share something. So I think there's three different ways. The jury's a bit out. I want to give credit to Bob for trying the different aspects of it. So that's my two cents.
I think that's a great
thank
idea.
You, Gary.
I think that's a great idea.
David?
Yes.
Thanks, Gary. Appreciate that. What day of the week and what time of that day do you broadcast? Is that pretty consistent?
No, you know, it's all it's a feed. It's a you pull my feed. I don't actually broadcast out. So I hope that I'll have time to produce this today and post it, and then I'll give you guys the feed. It might not be until, let's see, tomorrow, Monday. Monday's a bad day. If it doesn't go out tonight, it'll go out Tuesday.
Great.
It's up there, anybody can watch it anytime. It's up there in video in YouTube or on my Facebook page or on my webpage, and anybody can get it anytime. So as you have folks that are interested in knowing about you guys, and if you like what we put together, you just send them the link and they can watch it and go from there.
Excellent. All right. Thank you so much.
So we're
any
at about,
final yeah, any we're, final comments?
Yeah, anybody
just
else have any
money? Uh-huh. So I think what you said earlier was a kind of a key thing. This is a bit like Amazon has the long tail, which is basically that there were millions and millions of very, very small titles of books. That's how it got started. But because it was worldwide, global, there was a big enough audience for a specific small thing. Now, amateur radio is getting a little bit like that. It's very fragmented now because there's so many topics and so many things. And find anybody else in the same hobby isn't so easy. But utilizing this technology and augmenting our hobby means we all found each other. And if we have a very specific subtopic, even now, we can create an extra room, and it, you know, maybe it's just for VHF, UHF. So we can have, even inside that long tail, we can have even more specializations and special interest groups. So I'd say anybody who wants to come and join us, they get started in this more general area. But if people want to splinter off and do their special satellite group or something like that, then, you know, the people who are interested get in doing that. And the other last thing I'd like to say is we have no timetable. If you are, you know, in between meetings or anything else, I just get my phone out. I quickly go into Jitsi, have a look and see who's in. And sometimes there's like two people in, sometimes there's nobody. Any time of the day or night, it's 24/7. Unlike a normal club, you have very specific times. And COVID means that, you know, you don't know who's going to be a bit down 1 minute and fine the next, but you can just turn up here. It's a bit like going to Cheers pub or something, you know, you just turn up and you're full of friends.
I think that's a great point. You know, I come at amateur radio, you know, I learned about it and I've only been in the hobby about 10 years. I have become an educator because that's my style. I like to share and teach. And what I've learned by teaching and exposing myself to other things, I learn as much as I do teaching other people because we are exposed to new things. I never thought I would have a permanent, you know, Windlink station up. In fact, 2 years ago, I didn't even know what it was. And, you know, and now, you know, we sys off and we have this whole infrastructure here in Southern California where we can go pretty much from the San Diego, Mexico border all the way up into Ventura County, UHF, VHF, you know, hop to hop, where we can transmit without any backbone, without any internet. And so it's grown my level of, you know, interest in a certain area of amateur radio. And I can see bringing new people into this group will help teach them about what you guys are doing and help teach you guys about other things. So I want to just take this minute to thank you all for your time today. I do think that this is absolutely amateur radio, and I think what you guys are doing is awesome. You've created your community. You're supporting each other. How many of you have ever met in person? Anybody? A couple of you? Yeah. And,
We've already got three rooms on HamCam. So if the things are going bigger, people can agree about going into that with showing videos or having technical discussions. And here on HamCam 1, this is the, what do you call it, chat room. Mm-hmm. And then from there up, you can go into HamCam 2 and HamCam 3. So, and I've learned a lot of techniques here in this room. So thank you very much to all of you.
I haven't even met my neighbors, never mind these guys.
One of the things that Gary suggested in an email a while back was exactly what you're talking about, to have interest groups, specific items, and that would certainly address itself to going to another room if you're interested in satellites or you're interested in HF.
Yeah, topic of the day, sort of thing.
Yeah,
I love that idea.
Well, I'm interested in emergency comms, so I would be happy for you to come back and give us a talk about MCOMs, because that's a big deal for me.
I'd be happy to do that, and you know, I'll come back and do that, and actually probably what I'll do is come back, talk a little bit about it, and share some links to some of the shows we recorded on that.
David, Colin's going to add you to the membership list. Consider yourself a member.
Well, I appreciate that. And I did the Facebook thing, so hopefully it'll get back to me. I think with that, we're at a good stopping point. I want to, again, thank you all for spending some time with me on my Sunday morning. I'm not sure whether you're afternoon, evening, or into Monday where you are. But again, thank you for spending the time with me. I wish you all 7-3 and good health, and I look forward to seeing you guys in the future. When this is all done, I'll send it to Murray, and with that, I'm going to stop. Information again, and again, the Facebook group, and probably easier for the Facebook group to just search HamCam International and ask to join the group if you're interested. I hope you enjoyed it. I thought it was really interesting. It was great to see all the camaraderie there from folks all around the world, and you know, how they help themselves with amateur radio and getting through, you know, these strange and different times. And if you're interested, reach out to them. Looking to bring you some more shows coming up soon, probably within a week or so. I've been thinking about the new amateur radio license fees that were proposed, and I'm going to do a little bit on that. I'd like to talk about that and talk to you a little bit about my journeys with OneLink over the past 6 months or so. I hope you're well. I hope you're safe. I hope you're still doing amateur radio. You know, these are the times where we should be adding our skills, upgrading our license. If you're doing the MCOM thing, take a FEMA class or two. They're all free and online and available. And there's a phone call. Never a dull moment. And with that, I'll thank you for watching. If you're interested in supporting the show, please visit us at hamradionow.tv and visit Arvin and click the pig. The show is free for you to watch, but it's not free for me to make. Any little bit helps with the hosting and the software and all the other things I need to put this on. Again, I hope you enjoyed it. It's great seeing and talking to you again. I'm David Goldenberg, W0DHG, and I'm going to say over and out.